G'day legends, I'm here at Fletcher Park in Perth. We're about to get wet, the storm's about to come in. I'm with Snehal. Snehal, can you introduce yourself to our audience please?
Hey guys, I'm Snehal Pradhan. I played cricket for India between 2008 to 2011. I now work full time in cricket media, so writing, commentary, and I have my own YouTube channel, Cricket with Snehal, where I teach cricket in India in Hindi.
Another ICC final. 3 saal mein dusri baar and another hard working loss for India. Ye wala match to close bhi nahi tha. One-sided victory from Australia, jo 5th baar ke liye champion.
Awesome, awesome. So it's a pleasure to be here with her today. She's been here for the Women's World Cup matches at the WACA last night. Now take us back a little bit. What was cricket in India like for females when you were growing up?
Well, the first time I ever went to a ground like this, which is completely packed with boys, I was the only girl, and I was this probably tall, short ponytail. The coach there asked me to hide my ponytail inside my cap because he didn't want it seen that he's coaching a girl.
Wow.
So that's the landscape in some pockets. Of course, I was very lucky to have great support from my family, my parents, and the further coaches, the women's cricket community, which we have a history of women's cricket since the 1970s in India. So it's not as gone as far as it should have gone, but we have girls teams in most places, so I signed up with one of those.
Awesome, and it's progressed a lot in the last 10 to 15 years, I guess.
It's, yeah.
Whenever I've been over there, I've been to the Karnataka Institute of Cricket a few times, and each year there seem to be, the number of girls seems to be doubling. Is that what you're seeing as well?
Irfan Seth has done a lot for girls cricket in Karnataka, even before it came in fashion. After 2017, when the Indian girls went to the finals of the ODI World Cup, lost tragically against England, that since then it's really exploded. I mean, the girls, their salaries have gone up 4 or 5 times. There are more girls signing up in academies at the grassroots level, and just things have changed completely. The women's cricket team is in a spotlight, and with so many talented players, Smriti Mandana, Shafali Verma, the 16-year-old who's lighting it up. So there's a lot of good role models now coming up.
Awesome. Now, what would your advice be to any young girls watching this, whether it's in India, in your home country, or here in Australia? What do you, you watch a lot of women's cricket, you cover it, you're a broadcaster. What are you seeing in the game, and what advice would you give to someone who's trying to make it?
I'd have two separate sets of advice for people watching in India, because circumstances are completely different. Is that back yourself and just go through it, even if people tell you that no, it's not for girls, it's not something that's normal. You
back yourself.
Anywhere. There you go. And for, I suppose, people here in Australia or anywhere where cricket, women's cricket culture already exists and girls are encouraged, is just be the best, because that's a culture of excellence that the Australian women's team have put up. So the challenges are very different. So two different bits of advice.
Awesome, awesome. And now you're covering the Women's World Cup. What are you expecting in the rest of the World Cup? Who are you tipping to win the trophy?
Well, I actually had Australia winning that first match against India, but then I don't predict Indian games because you never know what they will do. Brilliant bowling from the leg spinner, who's literally this tall.
Wow.
And has hands this this big, and she destroyed the entire batting lineup, which just shows that, you know, size doesn't matter.
Absolutely not.
And I have a feeling, and I'm hoping, we should see an Australia-India final at the MCG. 8th March, International Women's Day. Imagine 90,000 people there. Hashtag fill the MCG.
Yep. Wouldn't that be a spectacular sight to see? Now, we're going to have to wrap up in a minute. It's about to bucket down here. Just give our audience a bit of an insight into how you transitioned from your cricket career into your broadcasting and your YouTube channel, everything you're doing now. How did that all happen?
It happened by accident, almost. I didn't plan it. I was writing a few blogs here and there just for a personal blog. One website said, you know, you write well, write for us once in a while. No formal journalism training, no training in writing. It was just something I developed and got better at the more I did. With YouTube, funny story, I started playing Pokemon Go. And I went on YouTube and I saw this YouTube channel by a creator in the US who makes daily YouTube videos playing Pokemon Go. And I thought I can do the same thing for cricket. And I gave it a go, taught myself how to shoot, edit, the whole deal which you've been through.
Yep.
And went through that journey, grown the channel now, 200,000 subscribers.
Amazing.
So it's been amazing, it's been brilliant.
Awesome. Well guys, what a great insight into an excellent cricketer turned broadcaster turned influencer, cricket personality. So Snehal, well done on everything you've achieved.
Thank you very
and
much.
And guys, make sure you head over and check out her channel, Cricket with Snehal. Some awesome tips and advice there, and we look forward to doing more with her in the future. Cheers, legends.
Thank you.